great pleasure to welcome you all to the 2022 Academic Achievers Awards evening. This is part of our reward and recognition of excellence in learning, excellence in teaching, and community engagement and integration thereof at UWC. Congratulations to all the awardees. You made us proud. I would also like to congratulate your families, your significant others, all those that assisted you during this time. Your hard work paid off. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this evening with us.
Hi everyone, I'm Tasrik Ferreira, and I completed my law degree summa cum laude at UWC in 2021. I am now working as a legal intern at the Equal Education Law Center based in Khayelitsha. In my second year of studies, I was selected to be part of the Accelerated Excellence Program, which is now known as the AEP Program. This is a program at UWC for high-performing students who excel in their first year of studies. This program was pivotal in the sense that it equipped me with leadership skills as well as entrepreneurial skills. Being part of this program provided me with an opportunity to develop as a person, but it also gave me an opportunity to have an advantage over my peers when I applied for job opportunities. And tonight, the students who will be announcers are all AEP students from the 2020 and the 2021 cohort. And when they announce from AEP to AEP, it means that the students who will be receiving the awards were also part of the AEP cohort in their second year of studies at UWC. And so, we will commence the awarding of the Learning Awards for 2021. These awards are presented to students in the following categories. The Best First Year Students per Faculty, the Best First Year in the Extended Program, as well as the Best Final Year per Faculty and the Best Honor Student per Faculty. We will start with the best first year across the faculties, and I thank you.
The best first-year student in the Faculty of Arts doing a Bachelor of Arts with a weighted average of 85.6% is Gopher Isaacs.
In the Faculty of Community of Health Sciences is, from AEP to AEP, Madeleine Davis doing a Bachelor's in Nursing with a weighted average of 88%.
In the Faculty of Dentistry, doing a Bachelor of Dental Surgery with a weighted average of 87.7% is Rachel Vermaak.
In the Economic and Management Sciences, doing BCom Accounting and with a weighted average of 81.4% is Latita Kivit.
From the Faculty of Education, doing a Bachelor in Education Foundation phase with a weighted average of 81.9%, Leila Khamildin.
In the Faculty of Law, doing a Bachelor's of Law with a weighted average of 85%, from AEP to AEP, Veronica Nguyen.
From the Faculty of Natural Sciences with a weighted average of 89.7%, Joseph Kasongo.
Well done to these students.
The next category is the best first year students in the extended program per faculty in 2021.
The best first year student in the extended program in the Faculty of Arts and Humanities is Pechelele Mashehane, with a weighted average of 77.8%.
In the Faculty of Community and Health Sciences, doing a Bachelor of Nursing and with a weighted average of 84.7%, is Amara van der Merwe.
In the Faculty of Economics and Management Sciences, doing BCom General with a weighted average of 79.3%, is Kim Small.
In the Faculty of Law, doing a Bachelor of Laws with a weighted average of 87% is Nompumelelo Ndwadwe.
Well done to these students.
The following category is the best final year students per faculty in 2021.
From the Faculty of Arts and Humanities, doing a Bachelor of Arts is Bronwyn Witboy with a weighted average of 85.2%.
In the Community and Health Sciences faculty, doing a Bachelor of Science in Physiotherapy with a weighted average of 82%, and from AAP to AAP is Sabrina Mitchell.
In the Faculty of Dentistry, doing a Bachelor of Dental Surgery and with a weighted average of 76.4%, from AAP to AAP is Megan Douglas.
In the EMS faculty, doing a BCom Law with a weighted average of 84.6%, from AP to AP is Cleo Khan.
From the Faculty of Education, doing a Bachelor of Education Foundation Phase with a weighted average of 82% is Tamarin Lobshire.
In the Faculty of Law, doing a Bachelor of Law with a weighted average of 82% from AP to AP is Myron Blair, Owala or Conte.
From the Faculty of Natural Sciences, doing a BSc in Physical Sciences from AP to AP, Craig Smith with a weighted average of 91.8%.
Congratulations to these final year students.
The best honours per faculty for 2021 are:
in the Faculty of Arts and Humanities, doing a BA Honours in Geography with a weighted average of 84.7% from AEP to AEP is Aiden Africa.
From the Faculty of Community and Health Sciences, doing an Honours in Psychology is Nicole Thomas with a weighted average of 81%.
In the EMS faculty, doing a BCom Honours in Finance is Michelle September with a weighted average of 79.4%.
In the Faculty of Education, doing a Bachelor of Education in Mathematics Education is Catherine Sakupapa with a weighted average of 74.1%.
In the Faculty of Natural Science, doing a BSc in Computer Science with a weighted average of 86%, Ezra Fielding.
Well done to these students.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Professor Lorraine Hassan, and I am the Director of Learning, Teaching and Student Success. The next section of awards is the Teaching Awards, and these categories are Best Emerging Excellent Lecturer Award, the Excellent Lecturer Award, the Most Innovative Lecturer Award, and Excellent Teaching Team Award.
Good evening, everyone. The faculty nominations for the category of Excellent Emerging Lecturer are: from the Faculty of Arts and Humanities, Ms. Carmen Rustin. From the Faculty of Community and Health Sciences, Ms. Megan Alexander. From the Faculty of Dentistry, Ms. Muriza Samuels. From the Faculty of Education, Ms. Timbisa Corsi. From the Faculty of Economic and Management Sciences, Mr. Muhammad Faiz Narkadin. From the Faculty of Natural Sciences, Dr. Keegan Poppas. Congratulations and best wishes to all the nominees.
Greetings, colleagues. Firstly, it is my honor and privilege to present to you our Faculty Excellent Lecturer Award winners for 2022. In the Faculty of Community and Health Sciences, Dr. Bay Smith. In the Faculty of Dentistry, Dr. Nicolene Podgieta. In the Faculty of Education, Dr. Patricia Jacobs. In the Faculty of Economic and Management Sciences, Mr. Venkoshni Matsubula. And in the Faculty of Natural Sciences, Dr. Omowunmi Isfahada. And in the Faculty of Law, Dr. Windel Nochir. Congratulations to each of the Faculty Excellent Lecturer Award winners for 2022.
The most innovative staff members per faculty are Dr. Benita Nell from the Faculty of Education, Dr. Fazlin Peterson from the Faculty of Economic and Management Sciences, and Mrs. Yaffa Williams from the Faculty of Natural Sciences. Congratulations on a job well done.
Good evening, colleagues. In this category, Excellent Team Award, we have two faculty teams in this category and no Institutional Team Award. Both faculty teams, however, has shown great teamwork and collaboration in advancing learning and teaching in their specific areas. We acknowledge their achievements. In the EMS faculty, the Excellent Team Award goes to the following team: Dr. Sims, Professor Anciano, Ms. Moses, Ms. Inkwazi, Ms. Scott. And in the Natural Science Excellent Team Award goes to the following: Mrs. Smith, Dr. Pierce, Dr. Opuwari, Mr. Mafika, and Professor Monsees. Congratulations to all the participants in both teams.
We now move to the Institutional Awards for 2021. These awards are in the areas of learning, teaching, and community engagement. In the Learning Awards categories,
the best first-year student at UWC for 2021 is Joseph Kasongo from the Faculty of Natural Sciences with a weighted average of 89.7%. Congratulations, Joseph.
Best first-year student in the extended program at UWC with a weighted average of 87% from the Faculty of Law doing a Bachelor of Laws is Nompumelelo Ndwadwe. Well done, Nompumelelo.
The best final year student at UWC for 2021 with a weighted average of 91.8% doing a BSc Physical Sciences from AP to AP is Craig Smith. Congratulations, Craig.
Student at UWC for 2021 from the Faculty of Natural Sciences doing a Bachelor of Science in Computer Sciences with a weighted average of 86% is Ezra Fielding. Congratulations, Ezra!
In the Teaching Awards category, the Institutional Awards will now be announced.
Now is the moment that all of you are waiting for. The Institutional Excellent Lecturer Award goes to Dr. Nicolene Podgieta. Congratulations to Dr. Nicolene Podgieta on this remarkable achievement and milestone in the higher education landscape.
It gives me great pleasure to announce the winner in the category Most Innovative Lecturer Award. She is Mrs. Yaffa Williams from the Faculty of Natural Sciences, and she wins the Institutional and Faculty Most Innovative Lecturer Award.
We are now at the final category of the program this evening, and it is the category of Excellence in Community Engagement.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed my honor and privilege to announce the Deputy Vice Chancellor's Academic Awards for Community Engagement Excellence for 2022. Our first individual award is for Professor Firdausa Vahi. She is the Deputy Dean of Clinical and Community Engagement and the Director of the Interprofessional Education Unit in the CHS faculty. Professor Vahi's learning and teaching approach and philosophy is one that is interrelated and reinforced by Boyer's model of scholarship. Professor Vahi has provided leadership, facilitates the development of interprofessional curricula and programs. She does capacity building, she does initiating and conducting of collaborative research and networks, and forges collaborative partnerships nationally and internationally. She has also got numerous publications, supervised several postgraduate students, been an academic journal reviewer, and is a member of many professional bodies, local and internationally. She has been recognized as a scholarship of engagement, leader through various awards. And one of the awards that she has received is the NRF Award for Community Engagement. She has also been key in the successful bid for the UWC Vaccination Center and is currently the site coordinator. And she has ensured that we have vaccinated 12,000 people at our vaccination center. She's also been key in organizing 2 outreach vaccination drives in Bellville and in Santa Kraal, and has also set up the vaccination center in the CHS building in Bellville. Professor Vahi is an example of an accomplished scholarship of engagement practitioner, and she has successfully incorporated these principles in all spheres of her academic practice. I would like to congratulate Professor Vahi on her achievement. Our next awardee is Dr. Lerato Makwena. She is a lecturer and researcher and author based in the Linguistics Department in the Faculty of Arts. The work that Dr. Makwena is involved in is an example of co-creation with the community to ensure the production of Mode 2 knowledge. Dr. Makwena has done this in an example of the journal article that she's currently co-authoring with Umpit Barense that elaborates the informational and symbolic function of the inscriptions on his baki. Dr. Makwena argues that socially just research extends to the rethinking of what we consider knowledge and the forms in which such knowledge needs to be presented in order to be seen as a knowledge. She also emphasizes the ethical practices and responsibilities that we have when we are engaging in research. One of the things that she emphasizes is that in the advancement of knowledge, in rare cases, we have, as researchers, have to guard against predatory dissemination of sacred information so that we protect that information from being commodified and sensationalized. She has also facilitated many sustainable partnerships, but one of those that I would like to highlight is the ones that she has been able to do so that she could host 2 very successful colloquia. And in these colloquia, she has brought together extraordinary professors, award-winning authors, cultural and community activists, NGOs, and emerging scholars. Dr. Makwena is also the recipient of funding for the 3-year NRF Tatuka funding. And she has also been able to, through this funding, develop a documentary which is being called The Broken String, which focuses on the discussion with the Bushman, Peter Barendse and Hans Springbok about the oppression and marginalization of the Bushman during and after apartheid. She is also serving as a mentor, confidant, and of the fellows of the MMU-IF program for the master students, the PhD students, and the undergraduate students. I would like to commend Dr. Lerato Mokoena for the way in which she has documented the stories of the Bushman in various formats, as it is such an exemplar of practicing the scholarship of engagements. I would like to congratulate our recipients of the Community Engagement Excellence Awards and acknowledge them as champions of community engagement at UWC. I thank you.
And now, as we get to the end of this virtual celebration, congratulations again to all the awardees and all the winners. Well done. We celebrate with you and we are very proud of you. To the first years, you have made it through matric and transitioned into your first year and you still did well. Amazing. To the final years, you've done the majority of your degree in the pandemic, and that is awesome. To the honors students, many of you have done your final year and your first postgraduate degree through a pandemic, and you have excelled. And that is something to celebrate. To our staff, you have been acknowledged tonight for adapting and enhancing your teaching practices to ensure student success. And for that, we thank you. We've also, at this point, have to celebrate and acknowledge those people who've walked the journey with you. Your parents, spouses, significant others, your children, friends, colleagues. I'm sure you will acknowledge that those nights would have been more bleak and more cold without that extra cup of coffee, that blanket, that I need a pen now, where's my pen? And somebody runs to fetch it for you. That understanding nod that it's okay, it too will pass. Thank you to those who walked the journey with you. We take a moment to reflect and take heed of UWC's motto, Respicae, Prospicae. Look back, look forward. While we're celebrating, let's look back. Let's look back and think of everything we've gained, of everything we've achieved, of everything we've come through, and let's celebrate it. Let's not forget it. Let's put it as part of our arsenal, if you want to use war terms. Let's put it in our back pocket, but let's keep it as part of our life skills. Something that we can pull out again when we face a crisis of any shape. We're also going to look forward, because these are the attributes that are going to propel us into our new normal. When we start seeing each other's faces again, when we can start celebrating face to face again. And remember that in these times, celebration was part of those life skills. We took moments to celebrate. Remember those virtual WhatsApp happy birthday parties where one adds another one and we all sing happy birthday together, but apart in our own places. We've had Zoom meetings, we've had everything. We didn't even realize that when we had computers in our offices that didn't have cameras, it didn't mean anything to us at that time. And now it means everything. Let's celebrate what we've come through. And for that, I'd like to thank Prof. Lavak for including a celebration
into UWC's academic calendar. Thank you to Ms. Kevin Bevu, Mrs. Janine Phillies for doing the admin for this celebration. I'd also like to thank Ms. Jessie Townsend from IA and the IA staff for always being ready to assist us in this event. Then I'd like to thank all the announcers, my colleagues, and to the AEP students. Thank you so much. We wouldn't have been able to do this without the support and the teamwork that we have achieved and that we do achieve throughout these celebrations. Then I think we need to go out. Let's go out, let's celebrate. And in the song of the sister of our own soil, let's go out celebrating. Go well, God bless.